Hi, my name is Irene Castrita, and welcome to another session of Boulevard Recipes Visits the Ethnic Markets on the Boulevard. Today, we are visiting a Vietnamese market called Minh Hoa, right here on 47th and El Cajon Boulevard, in the newly emerging Little Saigon District along the Boulevard here in San Diego. So today, I'm going to be making a coconut shrimp soup inspired by the ingredients we find in this market. So I'm going to pick out my shrimp. Kind of fun that you get to pick it out yourself. So here we go. So today I'm going to be grabbing some sriracha sauce that we're going to add to the end of our soup to give it a nice kick. So for our soup, I'm going to grab some fresh herbs. They have all kinds of different herbs. I'm going to start with some peppermint. I've had pho before, and they kind of it's kind of a seasoning herb they put at the end of the meal. And so I'm gonna experiment with that. I'm new to Vietnamese cooking, or to this particular style of cooking, which is kind of exciting. I'm just gonna experiment with the flavors I've had in the past and see what I can create my own version of it. So I'm also gonna grab some lemongrass. And then I'm gonna grab some basil. So I'm a big fan of bok choy, so I'm gonna grab some bok choy. Bok choy is a type of lettuce. But it's really yummy. It's low in calories, low in fat. It has a really nice crunchy taste. So it's something I can add to the end of the soup just to give it a little bit of flavor and a little bit of crunch, and experiment with the textures. And I also juice them. I love to juice, so I add them to our juices, and it gives it a really nice flavor, but it's really good for you. It has a lot of protein and iron and all kinds of nutrients that are good for you. So next, I'm gonna grab some ginger, and I'm gonna grate it up and put it in our soup just to give it a really nice flavor. I'm also gonna take some garlic. This is what's gonna give the soup a little bit of a nice kick and flavor. And then I'm gonna grab an onion. And this is kind of gonna be a nice base that we're gonna add with our coconut milk. And now I'm gonna grab some bean sprouts. These are always nice to add also at the end of the meal to kind of give it a nice crunchy freshness. And so this soup is gonna be a nice fresh, tasty take, my version of a Vietnamese soup. Okay, and also we're gonna grab some mushrooms that we can cook along with the shrimp and the onion and the garlic, and it's gonna give it a really nice flavor. The great thing about this store is they have a huge selection of noodles. I haven't really experimented much with them, but I will today. So I'm gonna get these light Vietnamese noodles. They're vermicelli noodles, and when I've gone to restaurants in the past, they use them in their soup. So I think it'll be nice to add some of the veggies with the shrimp and some noodles to give it a little bit of a consistency, so it's not a super light soup. But this is still pretty light because they're small noodles. So vermicelli noodles, here we go. Okay, so up next, I'm gonna grab some baby corn. I think this will be really yummy to add to our soup. And they'll be kind of fun for Galaxy to play with and eat. She really likes corn. So we can try this version of young sweet corn, and they'll make nice finger foods as well for her. Corn, elote. Up next, I'm just gonna pick out our coconut milk to add to our soup. I'm just gonna grab two cans, and then I'm gonna mix it with some water as well, and just figure out the consistency of the soup. So they have a huge selection of coconut milk, coconut cream, coconut water. So it's kind of fun. I've never seen so much coconut milk in my life. Up next, I'm just gonna grab some star fruit to just eat along with our dish. Maybe before, while the food is making, we can just snack on these. So these are really cool because when you open them, they have a really awesome shape. So I'm gonna grab a few. I love the color, the texture. They kind of don't seem like fruit. They seem like a jelly fun toy, actually. So this is a Southeast Asian store, so you get to find a really nice selection of fruits and vegetables you don't see at other markets. This is why it's really important to come visit these ethnic shops, because you get a variety of even these mango scenes, which you don't get to find too often in other places, and they're nice, they're real yummy. So this completes our shopping trip to Minh Hoa. Now we're gonna go experiment in the kitchen with some of these delicious fresh ingredients, and you guys will see the finished product shortly. Yesterday we visited Minh Hoa in the Little Saigon District, and here I am to present to you my Vietnamese inspired soothing coconut curry. So check this out, get a little closer. I created this curry using garlic, lemongrass, tomato, onion,
as a base, sauteed that a little bit with some tomatoes and added some coconut milk and curry powder along with some mustard seed. And I let that boil slowly until it was time to add all the vegetables. I added some shrimp, some canned corn, some mushrooms, bok choy, basil, and some cilantro, and a little bit of mint. So this is kind of my version of a coconut curry. And then I added some vermicelli rice noodles at the end to add more of a consistency and texture. And so now I'm gonna top the soup with some mung bean sprouts, a little bit of jalapeño. I'm gonna cut off some basil. And just kind of chop it a little bit with my own fingers so I don't eat a whole leaf. Okay. Then a few pieces of peppermint. And some lime for a nice kick. And sriracha sauce to add some of that spice. Yesterday when we were out shopping, my daughter Galaxy picked up these taro chips and she was snacking on them. So it's a nice contrast because they're actually sweet. They look like potato chips, but they're not. They're actually a sweet kind of honey version of taro chips. So it's a nice contrast to the spiciness of the soup, kind of this sweetness. And then I've never had this before. It's star fruit. And look how cool it is. It's star-shaped, and when you taste it, it's actually really tangy, similar to like a passion fruit. So I think this dish complements itself very well. Kind of the tanginess of the star fruit with the sweetness of the taro chips and the crunch, and then the creamy broth along with the vegetables and the fresh herbs just make this meal very complete and well-rounded. And you can add extra lime and extra spices to add flavor to your liking. But it was really fun visiting Minhoa. I've never gone to a Vietnamese market before nor shopped in one, so this is kind of the dish I created, and I'm really proud of it. So thank you for joining me as I visited Minhoa, the Vietnamese market in the Little Saigon district along the boulevard. Here is a dish, and I will be posting it on my blog so you can get further details on the recipe. Thank you so much. Till next time.